On this dairy farm in Sri Lanka, workers are digging graves for their dead cows. This farm bought 200 Australian cattle in late 2017 as part of a scheme to boost the country's fresh milk supply. Less than 50 of the animals have survived.
From the beginning, from the time these animals were brought here, from the very first week, these animals started dying.
The owners blame Wellard, the Australian live export company contracted to deliver the cows to Sri Lanka and help establish the dairy farms.
We should never go to Australia to buy cows, because the cows that came here are not suitable for our climatic, our nutritional, you know, availability, our budgets. They are not suitable.
Amal Suryagay is one of many Sri Lankan investors who say they've been financially ruined by the scheme. They claim Wellard hasn't given them enough training and support.
I think I have a cemetery, not a farm anymore.
Almost 10% of the 5,000 cows shipped to Sri Lanka have died. But Wellard says overall the program has been a success.
We had this small recalcitrant group of farmers that refused to follow the advice, and the specific mortality rate that you're referring to on that particular farm accounts for the large amount of abnormal deaths.
The company says it will proceed with plans to send another 15,000 cows to Sri Lanka.
To date, 84 million litres of milk has been produced. The protein and fresh food element of that for the people of Sri Lanka is a fantastic outcome.
The Sri Lankan Auditor General investigated the scheme and his conclusions were damning. He found the cows weren't suited to the hot climate, that they were too expensive to feed, and that they weren't producing the volume of milk promised. He wants the scheme stopped.
We are not to do it because it is a failure project. If you say that they import from Australia, I think nobody is going to buy it, because that message has been spread throughout the country. No, everybody knows this problem now.
Animals Australia has joined the calls to halt the program.
Well, it's been a fairly unmitigated disaster from a human and animal welfare perspective.
The Australian government's credit agency, EFIC, underwrote the $100 million deal. It said the program was now the responsibility of the Sri Lankan government. Lorna Knowles, ABC News.